Hallo en welkom bij Van Inkel's Choice, de best betaalde snabbel van Jeroen van Inkel, die hij daarom graag door anderen laat opknappen. Om de tijd tussen Countdown en het 6 uur journaal zo pijnloos mogelijk te overbruggen, hebben we vandaag gekozen voor een zeer diepgaand interview met...
Kom nou, schatje.
Hi, this is Janet Jackson on Van Inkel's Choice, Veronica TV 2.
Als je denkt dat er absoluut geen aanleiding is om 10 minuten te vullen met Janet Jackson, dan heb je het mis. Ze heeft dan wel geen huidziekte, doet het niet met lama's of Oprah Winfrey, maar heeft wel een nieuw album uit. We hebben het hele leven met haar doorgenomen, daar kun je van uitgaan. Over uitgaan gesproken.
I just get embarrassed sometimes. Seems like normally I'm the one who asks the guy out. That a lot of people feel very intimidated, a lot of guys. By me, I guess because of what I do, my profession. And I'm always the one asking the guy to go out or telling them how I feel about them first.
Janet heeft de afgelopen anderhalf jaar niet alleen een nieuw album opgenomen, maar ze heeft ook haar eerste bioscoopfilm gemaakt. De film heet Poetic Justice en werd geregisseerd door John Singleton. Janet vertelt waar Poetic Justice over gaat.
The film is about relationships between men and women, between women. It's about this girl, Justice, who has had a lot of tragedy in her life, as well as around her, in her community. She's from South Central, which is where all the riots and all that happened. It's a very, it's a pretty rough part of LA. A lot of the gangs and drive-by shootings and all of that happens there. How she deals with this tragedy is through her poetry. She writes poems. That's how she expresses herself. And she's very young. She's only 17, 19 in the film. And she's left alone, all alone. She has no family or anything. And she makes ends meet. She lives day to day she's a hairdresser. So that's basically how it goes, and it goes on from there. There's some violence in it, and her vulnerability starts to show. She's a very strong girl, though, at the same time. Very strong. That's the way love goes.
Als je met Janet Jackson boomt, dan is haar familie als onderwerp niet te vermijden. Ten tijde van het interview belandde haar zus LaToya in het ziekenhuis nadat ze in elkaar was geslagen door haar man. Het was niet de eerste keer dat LaToya op die manier in het nieuws kwam. Waarom, denkt Janet, gedraagt haar zus zich toch zo?
I think my sister has done this. Because out of all the brothers and sisters, she's the one that's never really had the success that the rest of the family has had. And by doing this, she's gotten a lot of attention, a lot of publicity. A lot of people notice her for this, and she's being recognized, I should say. And it's something that she's always wanted. I think it's a cheap way of getting it. And I think her husband has to do with that, because ever since they got together, she's never been the same. Never. And the person that is going around doing all the interviews and this and that, I don't know that person. That's not the person I grew up with. Not at all. Even when she did the layout in Playboy, it really surprised me. I thought she looked beautiful, don't get me wrong, but that wasn't like my sister to show her body like that. My sister wouldn't let you see her in her pajamas, let's just put it that way. And that's the honest truth. She wouldn't let you see her with her little shorts on and her little top. She thought she was too naked, and she'd, wait, I'm not dressed, and she has on her pajamas. I mean, that was my sister. And for her to show her breasts, and so I said, something's wrong. Something's wrong, it's not right. And I think he has brainwashed her and made her think certain things and say certain things. And I just hope that I miss her very much. And I miss the girl that I grew up with. And, I hope she's herself again someday.
Een familielid waar het iets beter mee gaat is broerlief Michael. Was ze tevreden over het Oprah Winfrey interview?
I loved it so much because finally I felt that the public got a chance to see that He's human. He's not crazy. A lot of people were saying that he was gay. Not that there's anything wrong with being gay, because I have a lot of gay friends, but that he's not. And that he isn't trying to be something that he's not. He's not trying to deny his race, and that he's proud of who he is and what he stands for, and about his disease, which I knew, and I knew that my mother knew, but that was it. I promised I would never tell, ever, anyone. I never even told my other brothers and sisters. I didn't know if they knew or not. But what makes it so difficult for me is I'm the one in the family that does, I think probably, if not the only one, but does the majority of the interviews, does the most interviews, I should say. So I'm the one that gets kind of bombarded with all the questions about the family. And people ask me questions about him and his skin, and it's like I want to say, you don't understand, but I can't say anything because I wouldn't break that promise for anything in the world, for anyone. You know what I mean?
De band tussen Janet en Michael mag dan wel close zijn. Ze moest van iemand anders horen dat er in december een reunie zal zijn van The Jacksons.
Yeah, I just found this out myself. A journalist told me. I didn't know because I haven't been home. But yes, they are.
Are you going to be involved?
I think they really mean not necessarily the family, but my brothers are going to get back together again and do something.
Including Michael?
I believe so. Yeah, I believe so. It'll be fun. I'm excited. That's going to be very, very entertaining, I believe.
Als we het over haar toekomst hebben, dan heeft ze twee doeltjes. Ten eerste wil ze meer cd's verkopen dan Michael Jackson.
Well, that's always been my goal. It will continue to be my goal until I get there, until I do it. Yes, that's one. I'm very competitive, and so is he, but it's a friendly competitiveness, and that's just the way we were raised. I'd love to sell more albums than he did. Are you kidding? I'd be crazy to say no. I think that's a wonderful achievement. More films, more albums. That's the way love goes. That's the way love goes.
Meer geld, meer liefde, meer broers, meer neuken en dus meer kinderen.
I'd like to. I've started with. My mother had 10. But she started when she was, what, 18, 19? And it's a little too late for that for me, I think. And plus, I'm a little too busy. But I would still like to have 12 children. I'd like to adopt. I'd like to have a few of my own and then adopt the rest.
Ik ben beschikbaar, ben wel benieuwd hoeveel zakgeld ik krijg. Tot zover van Inkel's Choice van deze week. Volgende week is de laatste van het seizoen, waarschijnlijk weer door mij gepresenteerd. Want ik heb een contract voor 3 keer, ondanks dat hij terug is van vakantie.
Reach out and feel my body. I'm gonna give you one.